In this video, we're going to be demonstrating how to use the move command inside of AutoCAD. So the first thing you need to do is make sure you have open the Student Edit Commands worksheet. Make sure the student layer is broadcasting, and make sure your object snap cursor has been unselected, and make sure your ortho is off for now. And then let's roll into the first move command section. So when we're talking about the move command, there are two types of moves that we typically do in the move command. We do strategic moves and we do non-strategic moves. A strategic move is when we pick a specific spot on an object and move it to a specific location. A non-strategic move is where we just pick it anywhere and move it anywhere based on just how it looks. I'll demonstrate the non-strategic move first. So if we go up to the move command and select move, or we type in move at the keyboard, the first thing AutoCAD asks us is to select the object we want to move. So I'm going to pick on this object. Now, nothing has happened at the command prompt because AutoCAD is waiting for you to tell it, hey, I'm done selecting objects to move. Because you can select more than one object. We could select 10 objects if we wanted to and then move them simultaneously. There's a couple ways we can tell AutoCAD we're done with this stage of the command. We can hit enter or we can right click. So the next thing it asks you is specify base point. So we're just going to pick anywhere. I could pick on anywhere in the object. I could pick anywhere out. It doesn't matter. This is the non-strategic move. So I pick on it and I just move it to wherever. That is a non-strategic move. Okay, that's very simple. Now we will demonstrate the strategic move where we're going to move the object to a specific location. So I'm going to hit the space bar, which will bring me right back into the move command, and I'm going to select the object. Then I'm going to hit enter or right click to tell it I'm done selecting the objects. And then it says specify base point. Well, I'm going to shift right click and I'm going to go to the center option right there. And I'm going to grab it in a known location because, remember, we're talking about a strategic move. Then the second thing I have to do is I have to move it to the center of that rectangle. Now, there's two ways we can do that. I can go shift, right click, and go mid between two points. And if my endpoint were turned on, I could select here, select there, and it would snap to the very center of that rectangle, just like our object shows us down here. But we have a new option as well. It's called geometric center. I'm going to click on that and I can go right to the center. Oh, something happened. Shift right click, geometric center. Here we go. And it moved right to the center of that rectangle. That is a strategic move. I'm going to do the same thing over here. I'll go to the move command. I could hit spacebar. Right click to tell I'm done selecting the object. I'm going to go shift right click. Center, click on the center, and then it wants that endpoint. Well, the endpoint's not turned on, so I'm just going to type END and click on the corner of that rectangle. That's also a strategic move. I could have typed in CEN for center and then the END for the endpoint of that rectangle, but I want to demonstrate as many different ways of doing this as possible. Then we'll move over to our last move section, which is right here. And the first thing it wants us to do is it wants us to move this circle up 1.5. So I'm going to go to the move command. I'm going to type move in at the keyboard. I'm going to select my object. I'm going to right click to say I'm done selecting. And because this is also a strategic move, I'm going to click on the center of that. The last time I went shift right click, now I'm just going to type in CEN for center. And I'll click on it. Okay. Now I'm going to go down and turn my ortho on so I can only move up and down or left and right. So I'm going to move up. It doesn't matter where because I'm now going to type in 0.15. Enter. And it moved up exactly 0.15. Notice we went from 1.75 to 1.9. Then it tells me it wants me to move the object three different times to these different locations. So I'm going to go back to the move command. M-O-V-E. Select both my objects. This is also a strategic move, but using direct distance. So I'm going to type in CEN. and hit the center. And with my ortho on, I'm going to type in my 2.25. There, it just moved. If I go spacebar, select them again, I can type in CEN, or I can go shift right click, center, click the center, and this time I'm going to type in 2.5. And then I'll hit the spacebar, go to my move command again. This time I'll type in CEN, and with my ortho on, I'll type in 3.25 and hit enter. So we've just demonstrated how to do a non-strategic move and how to do a strategic move in AutoCAD.